light, immortal light divine. Visit now these hearts of thine, and all inmost being fill, for without your grace all turns to ill. Veni Sancte Spiritus, Veni Sancte Spiritus, Veni Sancte Spiritus.
Good morning. Today is May 27th, 2020, Thursday in the seventh week of Easter. On behalf of St. Juliana Falconieri Catholic Church in Fullerton, California, we welcome you and we thank you for joining us this morning. The Mass readings today can be found at usccb.org. You can also find the readings linked at our parish website, stjulianachurch.org. We invite you to participate prayerfully this morning as Father Michael Pontarelli celebrates the Mass.
Spiritus, Veni Sancte Spiritus. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, his Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all and with your spirit. We've gathered together to celebrate the mysteries of the Holy Mass and to remember the life and the ministry of St. Augustine of Canterbury, the primate of England, a monk of Rome sent by Pope Gregory the First, Gregory the Great, to England to establish the faith there in the dioceses now of London, Canterbury, and Rochester. Let us remember the way that we've been faithful to the call of Christ and spread his good news and give thanks for the times we've been people of the world. We ask pardon and redirection to our salvation. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who by the preaching of the Bishop St. Augustine of Canterbury led the English peoples to the gospel, grant, we pray, that the fruits of his labors may remain ever abundant in your holy church, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. At Miletus, Paul spoke to the presbyters of the church of Ephesus. Keep watch over yourselves and over the whole flock, of which the Holy Spirit has appointed you overseers, in which you tend the church of God, that he acquired with his own blood. I know that after my departure, savage wolves will come among you, and they will not spare the flock. And from your own group, men will come forward, preventing the truth to draw the disciples away from them. So be vigilant and remember that for 3 years, night and day, I unceasingly admonished each of you with tears. And now I commend you to God and to that gracious word of his that can build you up and give you the inheritance among all who are consecrated. I have never wanted anyone's silver or gold or clothing. You know well that these very hands have served my needs and my companions. In every way I have shown you that by hard work of that sort, we must help the weak and keep in mind the words of the Lord Jesus, who himself said, "It is more blessed to give than to receive." When he had finished speaking, he knelt down and prayed with them all. They were all weeping loudly as they threw their arms around Paul and kissed him, for they were deeply distressed that he had said that they would never see his face again. Then they escorted him to the ship. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth. Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth. Show forth, O God, your power, the power, O God, with which you took our part. For your temple in Jerusalem, let the kings bring you gifts. Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth. You kingdoms of the earth, sing to God, chant praise to the Lord, who rides on the heights of the ancient heavens. Behold, his voice resounds, the voice of power. Confess the power of God. Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth. Over Israel is his majesty. His power is in the skies. Awesome is in his sanctuary is God, the God of Israel. He gives power and strength to his people. Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Glory to you, O Lord. Lifting up his eyes to heaven, Jesus prayed, saying, "Father, Holy One, keep them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one, just as we are one. When I was with them, I protected them in your name that you gave me, and I guarded them, and none of them was lost except the Son of Destruction, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to you. I speak this in the world so that they may share my joy completely. I gave them your word, and the world hated them because they do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. I do not ask that you take them out of the world, but that you keep them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. Consecrate them in truth. Your word is truth. As you sent me into the world, so I send them into the world. And I consecrate myself for them, so that they also may be consecrated in truth." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Oftentimes at common table in religious life, I was the sort of token Italian. You know, my parents were born in Chicago. When I was a little kid, I thought that was in Italy. That's funny, you can laugh at 11, I suppose. But we kind of kept Italian tradition in our house as best we could. And every now and again, as an adult in religious life, we would ask questions about, "Michael, how do you think all this stuff got started in our faith, if not by the Italians?" That's right. The Italians, some people claim, sort of invented a lot of our faith, And I used to tease the kids in the high school that really Rome is nothing more than a theme park for the Roman Catholic Church. But here's the point. When you go to that theme park, when you really believe the faith, you know that what we pray and what we believe and how we act has to be true. That we are a holy nation, a people set apart. That's right. What makes us holy but our consecration in God the Father, our consecration in truth? There's the truth and there's the world. And the fingers don't exactly touch each other, but they should come close. We as Christians are people of the world, but we as Christians are people in the world, but certainly not of it. And St. Paul is telling us that he's been working for 3 long years, and his labor doesn't want to sort of be in vain, because there are savage wolves that are come and be more attractive than the message of truth, than the message of the holiness that we are consecrated in. And we see that all the time. It's the advertisements. Not that Main Street or Wall Street or Madison Avenue is exactly the son of destruction, but they do sort of tear us apart from that which is holy, that which is sacred, that which is the truth. Buy this and you'll be like God. Buy this and you'll be better than you are. It's all the same original sin advertisement that Adam and Eve fell for, but we cannot, for we know the truth, that Jesus is Lord. The most important thing we could possibly learn in the Catholic school is Jesus is Lord. And the most important thing we can do as graduates and students of Catholic schools is to live Jesus Christ is Lord, for that is the truth, and we are consecrated in that truth. How would anyone know that we believe that, except that we respect life from conception to natural death, that we respect life that God has created, that we care for the planet, as Pope Francis tells us in his important encyclical Laudate Si. Let us be people of truth. Let us be consecrated in truth and live that truth, that life is sacred, that creation came from God, and that we're all heading toward God. Certainly, those voices will forever ring in our ears and be attractive to us. Let us have our first attraction as that of Jesus and Jesus as Lord, going forth to his people consecrated in truth, one with the Father. We live for him today and always. God bless. We bring our prayers before God, who invites us to unity with him, the source of our truth. For Holy Church, may she be guided in truth through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, living courageously, Christ crucified and risen from the dead, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all government officials, may the grace of God enliven their hearts for peace and justice. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who feel alienated, lonely, or cast off, and those whose human dignity is overlooked, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For each of us gathered in prayer, that we may be formed and transformed by word and sacrament, and be united ever more closely to the Holy Trinity, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For scientists, health professionals, public officials, and all who serve the common good in this difficult and uncertain time, that they will be filled with wisdom and understanding, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who have died, that perpetual light may shine upon them and they rest in the eternal peace of God our Father in heaven. For all who are ill, that God's hand will heal them. For everyone for whom we've promised to pray, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we ask that you hear and answer all the prayers that we offer you today. We do this through your Son and our Lord Jesus Christ, forever and ever. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer to you, fruit of the earth, work of human hands. It'll become our spiritual food. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer to you, fruits of the vines, works of human hands. It'll become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Our altar table is ready now. Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be found acceptable to God, the Almighty and loving Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands for the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate as our dutiful service. Graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus Christ, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended to highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder, mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our earthly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plene sucele et terra, gloria tua. Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venet in nomine Domini. Hosanna in excelsis. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer to you, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Kevin, our Bishop, his brother bishops, and all who minister in your name. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your great mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saints Juliana, Peregrine, Augustine of Canterbury, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, with words taught to us by Jesus himself, together we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that, by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. O Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always and with your spirit. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the table of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should come under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Body and blood of Christ, continue to bring me to everlasting life. Amen.
Communion Antiphon. When the Paraclete comes, whom I will send you, the Spirit of truth who proceeds from the Father, he will bear witness to me, and you also will bear witness, says the Lord. Alleluia. Let us pray an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Prayer to Christ crucified in time of pestilence and contagion. Dear Lord Jesus, Savior of the world, our secure and unfailing hope, have mercy on us and deliver us from every evil. We beg you to overcome the scourge of this fearful virus which is spreading from place to place. We beg you to heal the sick, to protect the healthy, and to support those who work for the health care of all. Show us your face of mercy, O Lord, and save us in your great love. With the intercession of Holy Mary, your mother and ours, ever close to us in our needs, we ask you this, Lord Jesus, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray. May our partaking of this divine sacrament, O Lord, constantly increase your grace within us, and by cleansing us of its power, make us always ready to receive so great a gift. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Our celebration is ended. Let us go and glorify the Lord by the way we live our lives. Thanks be to God.
Regina Caeli, laetare, alleluia, quiaque meruisti portare, alleluia, resurrexit, sicut dixit, alleluia, ora pro nobis Deum, alleluia.